Ever since I started my pro racing career, the Tour of Flanders was always heralded as one of the biggest races on our calendar. It was kind of like the World Championships of the spring, and I'd say it still is. The first time I did it was halfway through the race, was like an anti-climax. The whole bunch was still there and I was thinking, I thought this was supposed to be hard, and then it just blew to smithereens, especially over the old Clermont. And ever since then, that point in the race became my nemesis. But in 2017, I was just on such great form. The real turning point for me was making sure I was in the front of that group as we hit the Ode Quermont, and that was where I was able to maintain contact with all of those favourites, especially trying to stay on the wheel of Ellen van Dijk. She did a monster turn pulling for her teammate at the time, Corinne Rivera, and I just, all I had to do was survive because I had Annemiek in that small group ahead of me. This is the most important part of the course. Lupisto is there, so too is last year's winner, Armistead, or Diamond as she's now known by her married name. The race is really starting to splinter. Everyone is suffering. Sitting there in that second group in second position, letting Van Dijk do the work to try and close that gap. But Gracie Elvin doesn't have to close that gap. Being on Van Dijk's wheel is probably one of the most unpleasant things ever. The crowd there is insane. It's awesome. I wasn't quite sure who to pick. I decided to pick the Bols Dolmans train. I didn't get a chance to talk to Annemiek. I'm getting boxed in. I'm seeing Corinne. I'm thinking maybe her. I picked black. And I just had to come out right at the last minute. Oh, on the fence. So close. Go, go. Oh, I just felt like I just needed a few more meters. It was so close, I didn't even know that I got second. That podium was so good.
Watch the 2023 Tour of Flanders live and free on SBS Viceland and SBS On Demand.